Good morning to each one of you. My name is Sudeshna Roy and I am representing IHM Pune. I am heading the communication vertical here in IHM Pune and also looking after the course coordination for University of West London. I am immensely honored to have a wonderful guest in front of
thank
me,
you,
Ms. Jyoti Balani, who is an eminent food, wine and wine writer, food, wine, travel writer rather. And also has been a very eminent person in curating a lot of events with some eminent companies like JW Marriott. And let's hear it from you.
Yeah, from Mercedes-Benz. I'm mostly to luxury events.
Okay.
So I work with brands which cater to luxury, such as Audi, Volvo, Mercedes-Benz, and hotels such as Ritz-Carlton, JW Marriott fall beautifully to that category. So that's what I've been doing for the last 10 years, events, and I started writing in 2003.
So I would like to ask you, Jyoti, how did you start your pace into hospitality industry? When did you step into the hospitality industry?
I am a hotel management graduate. I passed out from MSIHMCT. I did a 2-year degree in cooking and a 3-year diploma in hotel management. Mrs. Ganguly was our principal that time. And my first job was with the Lovely, which is now the Sheraton. And you know, unfortunately, I was not happy working in a hotel, even though I enjoyed college quite a bit. For me, college was like a picnic. And I used to love all the extracurricular activities, which you don't see in other colleges, you know. But when I joined a hotel, it was very frustrating for me to be in the same place, do the same thing every day. And I started having a lot of doubts about why I joined the industry and why did I waste my time. But I was mistaken because, you know, I got a lucky break in Pune Times. The editor that time, Farida Master, she called me and said, we want someone to work on the Times food line. And ideally, we want someone with a hotel management background because they will understand how to do it better.
Okay.
And she literally taught me how to write from scratch.
Okay.
Although I had a fair flair for writing, but how to put it down for a publication, you know, how it should be published. So it was very kind of her. She was my first mentor as such. And that is how my journey began. Before that, I struggled quite a bit, you know, wondering what I should be doing with myself. It happens with a lot of creative people. They can't be doing the same thing every day, you know, and it's nothing wrong. But the point is that you should have someone to guide you at that point. If you don't get the correct guidance, you feel very lost. And these days, I feel students are very lucky. Because so many people, you know, guide them, they've gone through the journey. Especially your college, when I see that you have so much of mentors coming and talking. You, all of you, yourself, all the teachers are so marketing savvy. I think students are very blessed. Because we didn't have all those facilities during that time, even though we had very good teachers. But there were not so many options for hotel management students the way they are today. So now I feel, you know, I should also maybe guide students who want to pursue something different and don't want to work in a hotel. And it's not a compulsion that if you pass out from a hotel management institute, you have to work in a hotel. No, there's a lot of career options. And because they are trained so holistically, they are actually capable of doing a lot of things which other people cannot do. I'm not aware whether you know Sandeep Sapalkar also is a hotel management graduate and he's a very well-known name today in the photography industry. Because the way they teach you, the way they educate you, you become a well-rounded personality.
True.
And you can work in so many industries, you know. So I feel I'm, you know, now at that stage where if someone comes and tells me that I have passed out from a college but I don't want to work in a hotel, I completely understand. Because it can get boring, you're not doing the same thing
true
over and over again.
So that's the reason, like when we talk about the curriculum at IHM, like theoretically as well as practically, we have a blend of all four major course subjects plus management subjects.
Okay.
Because once they pass out, it's not that we want to confine themselves only to a hotel, only to hotels. We want them to, you know, spread their wings into hospitality industry and maybe a broader perspective into the service industry.
Sure.
Now, our brand is also now, you know, has taken up an initiative called Sahas, which is like, you know, supporting the entrepreneurship venture amongst the students.
I see.
So, which is the need of the hour, Atmanirbhar Bharat. So, you know, with that.
Yeah.
And lots of young children are really talented. They are so creative. And if they have something like this as a background, and the institute is also looking at your business plan, they have a panel of people to be supporting you, to be understanding your financials, where exactly do you need to invest.
Mm-hmm.
So I think so it's a wonderful opportunity for the students if they don't want to, you know, confine themselves to the hotels or hospitality industry or service industry for that matter.
Okay.
So that way they are, you know, blessed. And another thing which you rightly tagged is, we give them a lot of opportunities, you know, into things like, I'm sure you must have heard about Young Chef India, YCI, and YCI Junior, YCIG.
Yeah.
So actually these culinary competitions, you know, right, we do one series of YCIJ when they are in 11th and 12th, and YCIJ, which is the junior, when they are in, say, 6, 7, 8, class 6, 7, 8. So actually nabbing, you know, the talent at a very preliminary stage to give them that confidence and that platform.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I have seen that, you know, people, once they go through such sessions, they actually change as a personality. So what's your take? I'm sure you have, I think so, if I'm not mistaken, you have taken the interview of Anishka Sarwar.
I was just going to say
yes.
She's so talented, she's a brilliant young lady.
Yes. So how was it when you saw, did you take her interview when she was just the winner, or she had already joined college?
Recently, Yusuf put me on to her about 6 months ago.
Okay.
And I was very surprised and very pleasantly surprised at the way she is, you know, she's so media savvy.
Mm-hmm.
And she's so quick and she understands things so brilliantly. That means she's been trained really well, you know.
Mm-hmm.
The way she quickly responded to my questions on email, the photos she sent. She's so enthusiastic.
Mm-hmm.
So I was very impressed with the way that lady is. I mean, thanks to all of you. You have trained her so well. She's so polite and well behaved.
She's very, very professional. And, you know, she is the winner of the Young Chef India. And the proud torchbearer. And she's doing really good for herself. And then after that, she joined. She is currently in her second year of the college.
I'm sure she's
so,
really
and her specialization is food production. So just wanted to ask you, Jyoti, so when you shifted, when you joined through your campus recruitment, the hospitality industry, which is the field that you picked up, like where was your expertise?
No, I was, I trained in the Taj Pai kitchen when I was in college, and I wanted to work in the kitchen, but after the training, I realized that I am not again cut out for it. It was a very aggressive atmosphere that time.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about 1999. So it wasn't very conducive that time for women to work in the kitchen, you know. Because of several reasons which don't exist anymore. So I feel very happy when I see women chefs today. But in Love in Indian, I was appointed at housekeeping because they had a position and they asked me if I want to join.
Mm-hmm.
So honestly, it wasn't my choice, but just that there was a vacancy.
Mm-hmm.
And I wanted to work in Pune.
Mm-hmm.
I had this mindset that I don't want to go out of Pune. So I went and joined Love in Indian that time. And it was the only international chain that time. I'm talking about 1990.
Yes, yes.
So, so after a few days, you know, like I said, I started getting a bit frustrated over there.
Mm-hmm.
But then I taught in my college for some time. My principal called me and said, why don't you come and teach here?
Mm-hmm.
And then in 2003, I got lucky and got a job in Pune Times as a food writer.
Mm-hmm. So, what was the, when you were working in your college and after that, when you got this break in 2003, did it take some time for you to think, did you contemplate that, you know, is this the path, which is, because it's a less ventured path,
yes.
Like what enabled you to, you know, just take a pick on it and, you know, just move ahead with that instinct,
you know,
gut feeling?
Yes, just like you, you know, train your students and tell them what are their skills and what are their strengths.
Mm-hmm.
I had a teacher in our college who told me, you have a flair for writing. Which at that time I did not maybe, you know, think so much about, because I thought I'm a hotel management student, why will I think about writing? But see, maybe this is destiny or stroke of luck that I just called up Pune Times one day and the editor spoke to me directly and said, come over. And we want someone to work on the Times. I didn't start writing in my paper also. But now I feel that, see, being lucky is, of course, it's a blessing, but you should not rely on your luck.
Mm.
If you know that you have to discover your strengths and weaknesses and work on your weaknesses, of course, But you have to understand these are your strengths and that is the work that you should be doing, because that is where you will excel.
True.
So, like I said, now, you know, I always tell people that if you know that you're good at writing or singing or whatever, please pay attention at the right time. I wasted quite a few, like you correctly said, there was a gap where I was confused, you know, and I didn't know what I should be doing in reality, why am I wasting my time. If I had a mentor or someone to guide me and tell me that this is what you should be doing, then maybe I would have had more confidence at that time. So it did take me quite a bit of struggle that time. And eventually then I landed up at Pune Times and then I started writing. And then after a few years I met the Grove Vinyasa people and they told me that since you know the media, you know writers, you know hotels, why don't you conceptualize the event for us?
Oh.
And so again it was a stroke of luck, you know.
Okay.
And I did my first bite dinner at the Taj Blue Diamond. That time it was, you know, it was also one of the best hotels with very good food.
True.
So we did a white dinner and it went off really well. And after that I started getting offers from wine companies to do launches. And then in 2008 I thought of combining fashion with wine, fashion and art.
Okay.
Because every time doing a wine dinner, and you know, it becomes a bit boring if you keep on talking and people don't want to listen to too much of gab.
True. There needs to be a little bit of entertainment element in it. And
also, you know, wine culture had just entered.
Just become in, yes.
People were not aware that wine is not a serious drink. I mean, of course, we take it seriously when we talk about it, write about it.
True.
But it should not be made into such a serious drink that people don't want to even think about picking
associate it with a very formal kind of a setup where you know you're just talking about, you know, different kinds of wines, possibly taste, flavor and all, and not you know engaging the other people who would be possibly interested in a little bit of entertainment or drama for that matter.
Yeah, see, too much of gyan makes something very complicated and you don't feel like going near it, you know. But if you make it simple and fun and casual, everybody wants to have a glass of wine because there's not too much of things attached to it that you can't understand or whatever. So we decided to educate people in a fun way. So fashion with wine, art with wine, this is how it started. And then it went up to the level where I said I've launched a lot of wine companies in Pune. Because they found it, the media liked it quite a bit. Because we have to think of different ideas, you know, we can't keep doing the same thing over and over again. See, again, this is something which if I had realized when I was working in a hotel, that is a strength actually, that I can't do the same thing over and over again. It's not a weakness.
No, definitely not. Because you don't do it. Maybe you were not cut out to do a monotonous. Yeah. You possibly needed more energy and you had more energy to give.
Yes. And also create something different every day. Not keep on doing the same thing like a donkey every day. With all due respect to the hotel industry, but you know, there are certain roles where, I mean, some people are very good with it, you know, and I have a lot of respect for them. It's not easy to work in a hotel.
True, the hours
are so demanding.
You need a lot of tenacity, you need a lot of, you know, passion to be able to align to it. But then the beauty of it is the way that, you know, people like you who is branched out of that, you know, having that as a base doesn't mean that, you know, you can't venture into something which is so interesting.
So, even now when we do events, you know, I tell chefs, for example, I did a concept called the Art Brunch with Mercedes-Benz in 2018.
Okay.
It was in collaboration with Marriott Hotels, Mercedes-Benz and Diageo.
Okay.
And we got an artist to paint a Mercedes-Benz live on a Sunday brunch.
And
that was done in 13 cities all over the country.
Okay.
So over there also I used to tell the chefs that don't do a random brunch. You know, make artistic food, create something different. Because the media will not buy it if you serve them the same
run of the mill, yes.
And even the guests don't want to eat the same food every day. So even the chefs who work who have a regular job in hotel, I always tell them, why don't you do something different? You're a creative person, you know.
And in fact, when I was going through your write-ups which you've written on the chefs, it's very interesting also for them to have a write-up and for the people to know and have awareness as to what they are capable of creating.
Yes, especially after Sanjeev Kapoor brought out all the chefs in the open.
Yes, absolutely.
They should take that opportunity and also learn from him. You know, I've met him, such a humble person. After all that he has done, but he knows how to, you know, project, market himself in such a brilliant way.
Brilliant way.
So all of us should learn from that, from such people.
You will be so delighted to know that he is associated with us for nearly now 3-4 years and has always been a judge for us for the Young Chef Olympiad, which I was talking about. This is our 7th edition, which is just coming through. We are starting on this Sunday, 31st. and we are looking forward to 50 countries. Each time we always do it on a we do the launch in Delhi, and then the split up happens, and across we do the zonal finals. So heats happen, you know, based on the various sectors, and then the finals happen in Kolkata.
That's great.
But this time it is going to be happening on a platform, online platform, and we said that, you know, this is a tradition which we have started and we shouldn't do away with it.
Yeah.
So that's why, you know, and everybody, all of us were very excited. So everything, whatever that we have thought of or conceptualized, see, the thought process was conceptualized by David Fawcett, who is the International Hospitality Council head, and Dr. Subodh Bose, CEO of the company, 7 years earlier. And we've always done it in a physical way, and this would be the first time when we are venturing into a platform like this.
But I like your tenacious attitude and the fact that you're so positive. You have not let the pandemic kill your spirit.
No, in fact, during pandemic times, we came across a lot of you know, ideology. Thanks to kudos to the CEO, because if the person who is heading the organization does not have such a, is not such a visionary, it becomes very difficult for us to even, you know, percolate it down the.
You need a strong leader to guide you. Of course, that's very important.
Very, very important. So this is happening on an online platform starting. And then on Monday, Tuesday are the heats happening, you know, with each segment. So these people, what exactly is happening, different countries with their mentors and mentees are representing their respective countries, and they are in their respective locations, and we are just connecting with each other on a Zoom platform to be delivering what is expected as per the guidelines.
Such a brilliant way to work around the restrictions that we have currently.
Yes, and nothing like.
No, but kudos to all of you. Seriously, how are you working? It's so such a brilliant process, you know. I believe in this never give up spirit. No matter what happens, we should not let anybody kill our spirit. We should keep on doing our work and find ways to work around the situation.
True, true. And it also is very nurturing for the young talent, and then, you know, globally also you are uniting so many chefs together.
Absolutely.
And it gives a beautiful platform also to those students, you know, first year, second year, like every year it happens in a physical way.
Yeah.
So then what happens is that, you know, being a buddy to one of the country, their mentor mentees, you also get to get a flair of the culture.
Okay.
You know, and you understand that whatever that you're learning on paper is like what is happening there.
Absolutely.
You know? So, and then what it takes, I mean, when you're in your heats, you know, you have to, you know, manage your hygiene, you got to manage your time frame, you got to manage your structure. So you get into that, you know, built of maintaining certain requirements, which is expected of.
It's a learning, it's a new, something new we have learned, that which is so good.
True.
Even the pandemic has taught us so many lessons, which we have learned. We have learned different ways of working. I feel we're so empowered after the
year. So even during pandemic, in fact, we liaised with IBM, and we call it something called an ECPT, which is a common entrance test for your, you know, plus two students or any professionals who is exactly looking at, you know, what should I pursue as a career.
Okay.
So it's a 360 degree measurement of your psychometric test, where you understand as a person what is your competencies, and based on that it churns out the field that you're supposed to, you know, pick up. So this was during the pandemic that, you know, we bridged, we developed a relationship with our portal, and we said, okay, why not?
Yeah.
I mean, so that the students exactly know what they are churned out or cut out to be.
Absolutely. You know, exactly. It's a brilliant concept. Really, I really
admire all of you. So, Jyoti, just wanted to tell you, like, when you are writing, you know, you are in a different temperament, obviously. And when you are doing the curating of events, it's completely, you know, two different accelerations.
Yes, yes.
How different is it? Like, you know, what are the ingredients which are required for each of it for a person to be successful?
See, writing, like I said, if you have the flair for writing, you know, there are different forms of writing, by the way. There's an interview, there's a recipe feature, there's a, you know, review, a product review. So again, there are different sections. So I have been writing from 2003, I met the right teachers. So now for me, it's become like breathing, it's not a big deal. And as long as your basics are clear, because I am from that background, I spend
so much time to connect.
So it comes to me, I know the basics of food, the hotels, you know. And I usually cater to, now of course I like about travel also. Because see, in this industry and in any industry, you have to reinvent yourself. You can't be doing the same thing over and over again. So writing, of course, like I said, I was taught. And then you learn on the job from, I used to meet a lot of winemakers, for example. I met Abhay Kevadkar, he taught me about so many things. When you interview,
you get to learn, it's a learning ground.
Yes, everything you can't learn in college, you have to on the job learn. So, writing, I feel, is if you have some kind of basic training, you know, about the subject that you're writing is good for you. And you have to read a lot to be able to be a good writer. That is one tip I can give to aspiring writers, to read a lot of books, books, magazines, keep yourself updated about what is happening in the industry. So you should write about relevant topics which make sense to the reader right now and what will capture their attention. Events is all about being over there, the energy of the people. As a writer, you are alone. I mean,
it's like an individual contribution and is what you are doing. Yes.
But events is, it will, if you're a people's person, it will help you. So I like being on the other side also, because you get to actually meet people during events, you know, and connect with so many people, and you feel the energy over there. It's a synergy of different people who come together. Like I told you about the art brunch. So I got Marriott on board, Marriott Hotels, Mercedes-Benz and Diageo, and we came together for a common concept. All of us, we collaborate and then we create. We create, I mean, something which I have created in my head, I see playing out. So that's a very different high, you know. So that is a different, it's for people who like challenges, who like meeting people, and again, who are dreamers and creative people and like to do different things, you know. And also like to entertain people, because during an event, you are like in a hotel where you are providing a service to someone and bringing a smile to their face. In an event also, you want to delight the person, whether 1 hour or 3 hours, give them a different experience. So you have to like all that. You have to be a people's person and want to do something to make others happy. And of course, also to market the products that you are working with. You know, the marketing and PR is also comes into play.
Sure.
So that aspect, you know, comes into play also. So you have to decide which, if you're an introvert, being a writer will help you. And if you're an extrovert, being an events person will be the right job for you. I learned how to balance both of them.
True.
There are times when I want to go into my shell and only keep on writing and not be, I want to be disconnected. And then I want to go out into the open and do events and meet people. So it's a good balance for me, I feel.
Okay.
And you can always be multi-skilled and, you know, use all your talents and slowly discover that you're capable of doing much more than what has been maybe your perception earlier, in the earlier days.
How do you manage writing for travel? Do you travel and then you write?
Yeah, I've been invited by hotels.
Okay.
To stay there and write. And I have also been to 10 countries so far on invite. They have invited me, the tourism boards, to visit. That is for 1 week or 10 days they invite us.
Awesome.
It's called fan trips.
Oh,
yeah, where
awesome.
They host writers and they are the ones who arrange for everything, the travel and stay.
Okay.
And they make an itinerary, they plan out what are the highlights. For example, I went to Bordeaux in 2008, you know.
Okay.
And in college, we actually studied a lot about wine and
true. Bordeaux and Burgundy and all that.
So I called up my teacher from there, the food and beverage teacher from Bordeaux, and I said, "Ma'am, it's very different being there, you know."
Sure.
Reading about it and
being there, you know, and understanding how
it's like a dream come true. Yeah. I mean, you read about something and then you go there. It's such a nice feeling. So when you told me that your students, you know, are also
right from us. We actually, as I told you, Young Chef India is one of the things. Plus, when they come into the college, during their first year, we give them, let them go through a practical called, you know, buffet service, breakfast buffet service.
Okay.
So what happens, the entire class is split up into, you know, food production and food and beverage service. And we actually do a table layout in the restaurant, just like a breakfast buffet.
Okay.
So that when they get into their second year industrial training, they exactly understand how a buffet should look like.
Okay.
And what are the items, you know, it is always nice to see it, because when you see, you don't forget.
Absolutely.
You know, it's a picture image. Yes. So
right.
We do that. Even first years have a competition, it's called the Rookie Chef, wherein again, you know, they compete amongst all 6-7 sections.
Okay.
And one of them, you know, comes up as the, you know, each representing each campus. So again, 8 campuses, then they go to, this time they're going to go up to be representing. And then they compete against each other, and one of the winners is declared.
It's very fascinating. You come up with so many creative, brilliant concepts.
Yes.
Yeah.
Similarly, we also do in the third year, we do Super Chef competition. So again, for the food production specialization students.
Okay.
So for them to be competing again campus-wise, and the top 10, they compete in Goa.
Okay.
And whoever is the winner represents India for YCO, Young Chef Olympiad.
Okay.
So the Indian representation comes from you know, from one of the campuses, whoever That's has cool. been the lead.
Yeah.
So amongst those 50 countries, we from India do represent. So
I keep seeing a lot of your videos. I saw one with Rohit Dhar recently, and it was so, it makes so much of sense, you know. You have the best of people in the industry coming and talking to your students' life.
Sure, sure.
Which makes so much of difference. And
it's just during this entire lockdown, we had a lot of, you know, workshops by Randeepra, Kunal Karo.
Yeah, I've seen some of those on your Facebook page.
Yes.
Oh, there's always something happening.
So, and it makes more interesting because we have a lot of international chefs like Enzo Olivieri, Andrew Muller. So all these people, you know, they are a part of this, you know, competition, which also, you know, those are the well eminent known chefs, but Andy Verma.
Okay.
So we in fact every year we also organize something called a symposium.
Okay.
A chef's symposium, in which, you know, they talk about exchange of cultures, about, you know, what is the latest trend and, you know, creativity and all that stuff. So that is gonna again happen online.
Yeah.
Similarly, during this, there's another beautiful blending of culture which happens, which is called the United World of Young Chefs.
Okay.
In which what they do is all these 50 countries, they cook their traditional country dish.
Oh, okay.
And in a physical scenario, they would just display it and people would, you know, come and taste the food. So this would be for the writers, for the bloggers, for the media people to see. And
okay.
And it's a big one in the tourism industry.
I'm
and
sure.
something that is just like an Olympiad, which is a culinary Olympiad.
Yeah, absolutely.
Something like that.
Of course.
So it's a good forum for people to communicate, and we say that, you know, it's a global, so that's how the International Institute.
Yes.
So it is important not only the blending of the curriculum, but you know, practically also if that blend can be seen.
Yeah.
I mean, it's a different thing, and it's lovely to talk to you because we've always been talking to our students that, you know, it's not, don't think narrow, don't think, you know, four walls, and you know, there are so many now professional courses that you finish doing, and you have, it is branching out into so many different things that students
yes,
it depends on what you are interested in and where your passion lies.
Yeah.
Because so I would want you to, you know, give us at least two sentences about our students, so as to, you know, be third years, unfortunately, or fortunately, maybe they were fortunate enough to get a huge exposure.
Yeah.
But unfortunate that, you know, third year in a college, what happens? You always like to build up more friends, and you know, we always used to have the food fest in a bigger way.
Yeah.
You know, in third year, so they must be missing that. But apart from that, the learning which has happened, I mean, they've just lost, you know, a couple of months together in not being in the industry. But what's your take on how does the industry after the setup? Setback is moving forward and bouncing into, you know, different parameters. What's your take on that?
See, like I said, whenever there is an adverse situation, it brings out our strengths, you know. So we should not look at it in a negative way. This is what I feel. Like, I have always been a writer, but I also started writing about subjects which I never thought about. It gave us a lot of time to think about what we can, what more we can do. So I don't think students should feel demotivated or this is, and the industry is going to bounce back. In fact, I just saw a report yesterday on LinkedIn that the moment the vaccine news came up, the hotels have seen a 50% increase in occupancy.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, so and this is a global event, the pandemic. So a lot of people are affected on very huge levels, you know. So things that we may have missed out in the industry, I feel they are not that significant as the kind of, I mean, I've seen a lot of upsetting news. So I think we are better off because we have got the advantage of getting the time to also discover new talents about ourselves and branch out into so many different things. Like, I came up with a new magazine, like I told you, I got time to do it. So it's how you utilize the time and look at it positively, that this has happened also for a reason. Let us not think negatively, let us learn our lessons from it. And as far as your students are concerned, I have encountered just one, but I was very impressed. It said a lot about how you train your students. Yes, I told Yusuf also that that lady Anishka is so good. I was so impressed with her, and I in fact wrote on Instagram that I'm very impressed with the fact that she understands time management.
Mm-hmm.
She's media savvy, and she's so creative and brilliant, and she's so interested in what she's doing.
Mm-hmm.
She's very passionate. That is so important, you know. If you don't have the passion and drive for what you want to do, there's no point in doing it. But that young lady is very brilliant. So it says a lot about your students. I don't think your students I mean, looking at the way she is conducting herself, she's a shining example of how all of them must be. I'm sure. So there's no reason for any of us to feel that we've lost out on something. And the industry is on its way to recovery also. It's a matter of time.
True.
So in fact, it has brought all of us together. You know, there are a lot of differences of opinion, like it happens everywhere. But if you see during the pandemic, nobody was against each other. They were trying to help each other. They were trying to support each other. That wouldn't have happened if the pandemic would have happened. The human spirit, you know, always knows how to survive in these kind of situations. So I think this has also happened for a reason.
I guess this industry works on the Darwin theory, and we are, you know, survival of the fittest, and we belong to that industry. You know, hospitality has always been a bounce back industry.
Yes, obviously, and we have a lot of strength, mental strength in terms of, because we are a service industry. We know how to give, you know, so we should think about how we can help each other, how help others who maybe are going through a tough time. I have seen a lot of support on LinkedIn and all for the everybody. Been very supportive with each other. I've seen a lot of negativity go away during this time, in fact, because the human spirit has died.
True.
And also, we have learned not to take everything for granted.
True, and also started treasuring things which possibly we used to take it for granted, as if you
absolutely
were born with.
I go to the best of hotels and think it is my right, you know, to be now. Now I feel thrilled, even if, you know, I'm invited for a simple lunch, I feel, oh, I'm so happy. So we shouldn't take our blessings for granted, and, you know, even if you work for it, but thank God every day for what you have and your friends who support you, you know, the college where you passed out who has given you so much learning. So like I said, let us be positive about it. We have to see, this is life, I mean, ups and downs are part of life. This is what I feel. You can't let these situations run you down, or mentally, especially your mind. You have to remain tenacious and never give up.
True.
I've been working throughout the lockdown. It has not affected my work, at least.
Awesome.
Of course, events is because we couldn't do it. But as a writer, I have been writing about chefs, national, international, local, and reaching out to so many people, keeping in touch, and trying to keep up their morale, writing about them. You know.
I know.
And there's so many chefs on our international platform. Like there was a Loki chef, I don't know whether you remember, on MasterChef Australia, he's an Indian.
Okay.
Loki, and he's very good, Loki Madhiredi.
Okay.
So I was watching MasterChef Australia, and earlier I used to not have time to watch so much TV.
I understand.
So I saw there were so many Indian chefs on those international platforms who are performing brilliantly, and they are mentoring other chefs. So we got to see and hear so many things which we may not have
the opportunity
we
to
got
be able
the time.
To get that time.
We got the time to reflect, slow down. All that was also required. See, I believe the universe or God does things with a reason. So instead of complaining and cribbing that why the pandemic, we should learn lessons that it has come to teach us. You have to learn. There's a lesson which needed to be learned. So we have to understand those things and then move on with life. Things will get better.
It was such a lovely interaction with you, Jyoti. And thank you so much for such motivating words for our students, for them to look towards the industry with a new perspective, look towards hospitality as a profession with a new perspective, and then, you know, options of branching out. It was a pleasure.
It was an honor to
thank you,
Sudeshna. So nice of you to invite me.
Thank you so
thank
much.
You.
That's all for today. I'm signing off, Sudeshna Roy from Pune Studio.